All right, so here's Sep. What are we doing here today?
So it's British Dentist, second ever match. We're playing against the London Business School.
All right, how are you feeling for the game?
Yeah, feeling good, good team. Boys are just warming up now. Should be out there in a few minutes and hopefully get the win.
Okay, ones to watch?
Ones to watch, probably Anas and Brandon Taylor.
Okay, fair. Score predictions?
I'm going to go 3-0.
Okay, 3-0.
Yeah.
Say no more.
When a good thing goes bad, it's not the end of the world, it's just the end of a world.
According to Sep, you're one to watch, bro. Thoughts?
I think, instant, don't know what team's like, but I think we're going to do well. We've got a lot of talent in the team, so...
Love it.
Fingers crossed.
Okay, so welcome back to the Cusp of Balotelli channel. Today we've got something a bit different. It's the British Dentist FC. As you heard Sep talking there, we've got some 11ASIDE content. Sepehr, the captain, was just explaining what it is. Basically, a group of dental students, dentists from around the country coming together, playing some 11ASIDE football. Big shout out to Sepehr, the captain, and Brandon, the vice captain, both from Barts, for putting these games together. This game is the British Dentist FC versus London Business School. And here is the lineup for today's game. There's a few familiar names. In goal, we've got Luke, the centre back partnership of Brandon and Vency, right back Sepehr, left back me, Wilf and Cameron in central midfield, Tishok on the left, Umar on the right, Anas, you all know about him, in number 10, and Joe Benro up top. Before we get into the video properly, make sure you drop a like on the video and subscribe to the channel if you're new. We got new videos coming out every Sunday and we're back playing football now, so the content's going to be fresh, content's going to be regular. Okay, so it's the British Dentists here in blue, shooting from right to left, London Business School in red. They've got a throw in here, Brandon's well up to win the first header, Tishok gets up and wins the second. Ball comes loose here, gets played forward by the Blues eventually. Joe wins this challenge here and he starts running and he just doesn't stop. Ball with the opposition keeper here. He goes for the short pass out to the far right over there. That's Umar over there on the high press. He wins it. He's free. He's got loads of space now. He's going to cross the ball in. Tishok can't quite get the finish off though. Comes loose to Wilf though. Shoots, but it's wide. Here I am receiving the ball on the left hand side from Brandon. I must say it's a pleasure to play with a guy like Brandon Taylor. Very good footballer, so composed on the ball, you can always give it to him. I give it down the line to Tishok though, it gets kind of snuffed out. Don't make much progress down that left side this time. Ball gets played over the top, I win that challenge there. Brandon's on the ball again and he gives it into Cameron, number 11 in the midfield there. He's going to turn and try and drive. He gets challenged in the midfield there. That's Wilf here with a nice spread pass over to the right, but unfortunately nothing comes from this. Red's on the ball here, but it's some lively pressing from Joe and Tishok here down that left hand side. Eventually they make the mistake. Joe's onto it, Tishok's onto it as well, puts it up in the air. Joe flicks on, that's Wilf. Wilf finds the pass through and Tishok's through. Blue throwing on this left hand side here, I'm going to take it. It's a red flick on, but it means that Joe's through. Red's on the ball here and we're under a bit of pressure. This guy passes out wide to the right. I'm there though. I get the first challenge, but I get a bit unlucky. He breaks through from it. Again here, I slide in. I get a bit unlucky. That guy gets the ball. Cameron comes in. The shots for a penalty, but it's just a free kick on the edge of the box. Here he is, that man, Brandon Taylor. They call him the dental Sergio Ramos. I'm going to give it back to him here. And he's going to find a great knock over the top to Tishok. Keeper did well there to come out quite quickly and clear that ball away. Meanwhile, Anas is going to win the ball in midfield here. He's going to play the pass through to Joe. And again, the keeper's out very quickly to cut out the pass. Red's on the attack here, but the ball's going to come loose to me. And now I've got three options. I could pass it back to Brandon, could come wide to Wilf in the 12, or I could just clear it. But here's what I do. Luckily, the red striker let me off there. That was pretty poor from me, I can't lie. I got away with one there. If there's any Marvel fans watching, you'll probably remember the scene in the Battle of Wakanda where Captain America and Black Panther are just running headfirst into the line of battle. If you can't remember what that looks like, I'm going to show you. Yeah, a good bit of recovery pace from me there to make up for that earlier dodgy clearance. They're going to take the throw in though. They're going to switch over to the right hand side. But I think that's Umar over there doing well on the right hand side too to clear it. They're going to take this throw in over on that far side. Their guy there is going to cross it in. I misread the flight of this ball and there's their guy behind me who manages to get onto the ball before me. And all I can do is foul him. Plays over on the far side now. It's a monster throw in from Cameron to get the ball forward down the line. We win the second one. Cameron's going to take it again. And this time Umar is just going to decide to take it past everyone.
What a goal.
Gotta take another look at that one. Great goal from Umar there to open the score. And he picks up the ball here, takes it past one red, takes it past two, takes it past three, and then he's through on goal. And it's a great finish with his left foot down to the keeper's left. 1-0 up now, and I feel like we've deserved it so far. But the Reds are playing just as well, so they are still a threat. Straight from the kickoff though, Anas chasing up the ball. He's gonna win one. Sep wins the second. Now it's free to Anas. Anas looks for the ball through to Joe, but he's just strayed offside. Nothing comes from this, but I just wanted to leave this chest control from Wolf in. Sep over there on the far side with the ball in the right back position. He passes forward but gives the ball away to the Reds. Reds come forward now, breaking in numbers. This guy gets a shot on the edge of the box, but it's wide. Playing out from the back again here. Brandon's on the ball. He gives it out to me on this left back position. I pass it down the line to Tishok. Tishok tries a nice little flick inside. It comes off. He's gone now. Wolf on the ball here. And he switches it over to the other side. But the Reds head it away. The Reds here playing some nice football. They do pass the ball quite well. They are knocking it around quite nicely. And they are capable of creating chances. So this one goal lead at the moment isn't safe. As they're passing it around here, here's their number 9, he passes inside. They're going to keep the ball. Wilf's going to try and win this challenge. He can't. There's the number 4 on the ball here. He passes again. Some good passes from them. This guy's going to cross it in. He finds his mate, but the ref's going to blow for offside. Their goalkeeper's going to go for the big drop kick. I shouldn't really let this one bounce here, but it's okay because I win the second ball. Tish is going to come in and help me out. He gets the second challenge. And now he's away. He's gone past his player. He's found the pass through to Joe in the center of the box. He's got the chance. He shoots, but it's just wide. First sub of the day, that's Connor coming on into the midfield. He is a very good player. And that's us taking a free kick from deep, but nothing much really comes of it. Meanwhile, Joe's trying to hide his lockdown trim. Tishok on the high press here, and I can't lie, he gets sold a home whitening kit. Remember when I said Connor's a very good player? Just watch this.
Nigga wanna see me fall. Stephen Curry, how I ball. Dolce Gamma, Santa, my dream on my body.
Brandon Tiller to win that header right there. It's a great header forward. Anas picks up the ball and it is an amazing switch pass over to Tishok on this left hand side. Tishok's got the pace. He's going to chase onto it. He's there, he's standing up his defender. He gives it back to number 12. That's Wolf. Wolf cuts inside, shoots, but the shot's tame. Like Sep mentioned earlier, this is BDFC's second game only. And for a team that doesn't really know each other that well, it's a mix of dentists and dental students from all over the place, really. We're playing quite well. And that's Cameron running onto the ball there from Birmingham, but the keeper comes out quickly. Nothing really comes of this next clip here, but Tishok asked me to keep all the flicks and tricks in. So here you are. Luke in goal here is going to roll out to James Bentley, who's come on to replace Vency at centre back. James is a hospital dentist, and he's going to pass it into Connor. Connor's going to pass forward. That's Umar on the touch. Umar passes over the top to Cameron, who's almost through, but the touch takes him backwards a little bit. He does well to ride the challenge. And here's number 14, Tishok again. He's going to cut and shoot, but it's just a bit high. They done Tishok with this dummy earlier, but I wasn't going to let them do the same to me. Red's looking to play forward here. Brandon wins the first one. James Bentley wins the second one. Good pass out to me on the left. I give it to Tishok and then I'm gone for the overlap. Tishok looks to find me, but I think he ends up finding someone else. That's Umar. He wins the throwing high up the field. I tried to take it quickly, but they win the header. That's Cameron pressing the ball with Anas. Anas wins it. He wins out the challenge. He's going to try and drive forward. He eventually breaks free, gives it to Tishok, and there's shouts for a penalty here, but the ref doesn't give it. Dentist counter-attack over on that far side. We win the ball from their throw-in, and that's Anas bringing the ball forward. He cuts inside and he's going to pass over to number 14, Tishok, on this left-hand side. Tishok's going to look for the pass inside. He finds a nice one over to the right-hand side. I think that's Umar. Umar shoots, but the keeper saves. Big throw in from me here to cause some problems straight into the box, causing all kinds of havoc. They try to clear out, but that's Anas with the snapshot, but it doesn't trouble the keeper much. Just wanted to leave this tackle in. It's a great challenge in the middle from Connor here, and he wins a free kick for his troubles as well. Coming towards the end of the first half now, and it's been a decent half for the boys in blue. I can't lie, for an 11-a-side team that hasn't played much together, like Sep said, it's only the second BDFC match, and even then, it's a lot of different players from the first match as well. It's been okay so far, 1-0 at the moment. Ref's going to blow the half-time whistle soon. We've had quite a few chances in this half, and there's definitely going to be more opportunities for us to score in the second half. We just need to be a bit more clinical and a bit more tidy in possession, I'd say. But at the same time, the Reds can be quite dangerous as well. They do pass the ball around quite nicely, so they are still a threat.
And don't be scared to put your foot on it. Turn around. We're always going to be at the back with so much space. And we can get the ball, we can just fizz it back around the other side. It's as easy as that, but let's not take our foot off the gas. Keep looking left and right, pick the man up, win the first ball. And I think they're going to tire, because they're running a lot.
Running ragged already.
There's goals in front.
Definitely.
If they're 15 yards away with the ball at their feet, you don't have to press. Yeah. They're going to do one or two things. They're going to go long or they're going to bring it out. But if the keeper's passing it to their feet and their back is to you, that's when you press. Or if they take a dodgy touch, then you press again. Be loud, shout when you're near them. Force a mistake. Get right as close to their arse as you can.
We are playing well.
Good foot. One thing I had is he's not a goalkeeper. He's using his feet too much and he can't use his hands. So, yeah, basically, have the pot shot and run him because he won't catch him. Good?
Let's keep it
short.
Yeah, keep it moving.
There is goals.
They are wide.
We're going to beat them every time.
Okay, so second half's going to get underway and it looks like Anas can't wait for the clubs to reopen. Okay, so Blues to kick off here, this half. We're looking to get some more goals, you know, that 1-0 lead is always a dangerous one. So this half, we want to get some more goals, try and control the game a bit more and, you know, not really let the Reds back into the game. We're just knocking it around the back here, starting off the half nice and early. That's Wilf on the ball in the middle. He's passing it back to Brandon. Brandon, that's Connor, number 13, and he looks to pass forward, but the pass is cut out by the Reds. Vency here, the 6'2" Bulgarian from Plymouth, looking like the gaffer, blocking out the camera. He's encouraging the boys from the sidelines there. The ball's over on the far side. Can't really tell who that is cutting in there. But Cameron wins the second challenge, passes it out wide to Tishok. Tishok looks to come inside, he takes it past one, takes it past two, but the third one gets a nice challenge in. At half time, Luke told us to take more shots because their keeper's dodgy. Anas heard him, but this one ain't going to test him. Straight away though, they're going to take this goal kick short pretty quickly, and they're a bit dodgy from the back. That's a dodgy pass there. Tishok's on the high press, he intercepts very well, he gets the cross in. I think that's Joe there with the touch. He can't quite turn and get the shoot, but he drops it off for Connor, who gets the shot, but that's just wide. It's been a good start to the half for us, as Brandon Tiller's got the ball over here. He's going to pass all the way over to me in the left back position on the other side now. I'm going to pass it into Tishok down the line. He tries to turn his guy, but the red player does well. Tishok does even better though to win the challenge. Now he's going to break free. He passes forward, and I think that's Joe that gets fouled. Quick thinking from the boys as we take the free kick quickly, and that's Anas. He's going to look over to the right. He finds Wilf, but unfortunately the pass takes him a little bit wide. Wilf's going to look to get the cross in, but the red player blocks it. We win a throw in high up the pitch. The London Business School coming forward now. Connor makes this interception here, and he looks forward straight away, finds a great pass through to Anas. Anas is through on goal, but the ref calls it offside. Anas puts it in the net, but there's no way that's offside. Red free kick here, and Tishok's on that high press again, and this time we get rewarded for it. Tishok passes across, he makes Joe work for it, but in the end it ends up in the back of the net. Let's take another look at that. It's great pace from Tishok to win the ball here, and then he's gone. He's got the vision to find Joe. The pass makes it a little bit difficult for him, but it's a goal nonetheless. Big lump forward from the red player there. I think that's Sepehr winning the ball in there, and that's Wilf. He passes forward. We find Connor, number 13 here, and then he passes over to our number 10, Anas, on the right hand side. Anas tries to take it past this guy. Sep puts the ball in though, and that's Tishok on the end of it. The first touch is good, the second touch, the red gets there, and then they manage to get the ball away. We're 2-0 up now, but even then 2-0 is still a dangerous lead against a team that can pass the ball around well. That's Wilf towing the ball forward to Anas here. Anas is going to chase onto it, and he stands up his opponent, but then they literally have like 2-3 guys on him, and eventually that's got to be a foul there, but the ref doesn't give it. Venti, the 6-2 Bulgarian here at the back, is going to receive the ball. He's going to pass it into Wilf, and I had to keep this little turn in. Tish recommended that I watch a documentary called Seaspiracy. He said after the documentary he didn't feel like eating fish anymore. He said he doesn't mind chips though. Great ball over the top from Tiller there, and it's a great finish from Tishok, but unfortunately it's not going to count for offside. Meanwhile, Joe's doing a passing drill on the pitch with the other team. They look to take this free kick along the floor into the middle of the pitch, but we intercepted. That's Connor there. James picks up the loose ball and passes back to Brandon, I think. Brandon goes out wide to Tishok. Tishok lays it off back to me, and I give a good ball over the top to Brandon, who's continued his run from centre back, but he can't get the cross in. Red's goal kick here, and again we win the ball in the middle of the park. That's Anas winning the first one. The ball's going to break free to the 6'2" Bulgarian Venti, who comes flying forward. He finds Tishok with a pass. Tishok finds Brandon Tiller at the back. Tiller again, he passes forward, and he's going to continue his run again. Very attacking from centre back, but the ball gets cut out. Midway into the second half, and as you can see there, I'm being subbed off for Cameron.
Not happy, bro.
No, I'm not.
Been subbed off.
Aww.
Okay, so I turned off the camera for a sec here and just restarted it. Luckily, I managed to just get this in. It's our corner, Anas is gonna take it, and this is why we call him the Dental Sergio Ramos.
I just got it. Just got it, I think. Just got it.
You think?
I think I just got it. I knew Brandon was going to score. Put in the predictions.
Let's take another look at that. It's a great delivery in from Anas, and it's a fantastic header from Brandon Tiller. Kind of reminded me of like Drogba at the near post. Makes it 3-0, and that's his second goal in two games for BDFC. I left Anas's laugh in here just for the good vibes.
Chelsea lost 5-2 to West Brom.
They lost 5-2
to West Brom.
Before the game, before this game, they were 2-1 down.
Sam Allardyce's special power.
Reds coming forward here down this left hand side. Their number 10's got the ball. He takes it past Connor. Connor fouls him a little bit, but the ref plays the advantage. 17 plays it over the top, but Brandon deals with it.
Come on, mate, there's a goal here for you. And you want to come off? I'll go on up front. Sep, Anas is leggy.
Maybe he just took damage. Mate, Tish, best player on the pitch. He's playing really well. Everything's come for him, that's it. He hasn't scored yet, that's shame. He's playing really well.
Who do you think? Player of the match so far?
Yeah, I don't know his name, but
which number?
He's playing left wing.
14?
Yeah.
Tish?
So, yeah,
brown
Tish.
Guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's playing Tish. Very Tish.
Right. But since I've come up, he's been quiet. He needs me there, bro.
Anas! I'm here if you want, yeah?
So the Reds are a team from London Business School, and for some reason I'm not sure why a lot of them speak Spanish. I don't really know what this next part means though. Reds getting a chance on goal there, but luckily for us, they couldn't finish it off. Tiller on the ball, he goes for the long pass to Tish. It's some great chest control from Tish. He brings it down very nicely and lays it off into the center. We look for the pass through, and the keeper should just pick it up, but he does something a bit dodgy, parries it away. But then the centre back gets the ball away for good for a throw-in. Meanwhile, Tiller on the pitch is going to do his best King Julian impression from Madagascar.
Move it.
Meanwhile, Cameron's going to take this throw-in, and we've got shouts for another penalty. Joe does really well to stay on his feet there, but if he goes down there, that's a penalty. It shouldn't really be that way, but you know, that's how it is. The ref's really not going to give the penalty unless Joe goes down there. Tishok's attacking down that left side again though. He's got the pace, he's going to stand up his man. He gets past him and then he gets fouled. Wilf's back on the pitch now. He's going to pick up the ball in the centre here. Well, he wins this challenge quite well, and he's going to drive forward. He finds the pass out wide to Tishok. Tishok's going to drive. I think that's Joe in the centre trying to go square for him, but this time Tishok can't find him. Our corner from the far side here, and there's no way Brandon scores two in one game. Yeah, Brandon really should have got his second goal of the day. There was a golden opportunity to make it 4-0. But here we are again, winning the ball from their free kick. That's Anas finding the pass through to Tishok. and all they can do really is just foul him out there. 3 kick comes in and it's yet another chance for Brandon at the near post. Okay, so I'm back on the pitch now, left back, but the Reds coming forward here. Sepp's challenge is good, but it doesn't quite do enough. Reds still on the ball. They get a good passing move together here. Nice little triangle. They get the cross in, but Brandon heads it away. It comes out to the edge to their guy. They shoot. It gets blocked out for a corner. Venti on the ball here, gives the ball out to me out wide, and this bit reminded me of that Kurt Zuma run where he just ran the length of the pitch. I was looking for a pass, couldn't really find anything, chuck a couple step overs in there, why not. Eventually a guy comes flying in with a slide tackle and gets out for a throw-in. Throw-in's not great from me though. The Reds get the ball and they're breaking straight away, counter attack. They're through. Sepp's chasing him, it's a great pass. Sepp's chasing him, Vency's chasing him, but the 6'2" Bulgarian gets a perfect sliding challenge in to snuff out the danger.
Anas, knuckleball.
Coming towards the end of the game now, and we're 3-0 up, but we really want that clean sheet, and the Reds are looking a bit more dangerous as they come forward. Great pass through, but Brandon gets a big block in to stop it. Their corner now, and Luke in goal, who hasn't had much to do all game, comes out and very confidently picks this ball up. Reds trying to come forward down this left hand side here. They pass it inside, but that's James winning the challenge in there very nicely. He gets the ball forward to Cameron. Cameron gives it to Umar out wide. Umar looks to drive into the box. First cross doesn't work. Second one, he tries to take it past him, and again it's another penalty shout, but the ref's not having it. Anas is through on goal here, but I think he's tired. First game back, you know, after 3 months in lockdown. Usually he finishes that. And I've got to shout out my man Han here, Anas's brother, for helping us film this. He recorded the whole game, but Cameron's not going to be happy with this, the way he walked past the camera now.
Huh? We have to see, innit? Yeah, but the 20% came up.
What a sensational goal from Cameron there. We got to take another look at it. It's a good first touch and then some good footwork to take it past this guy, and he strikes it and shoots. Keeper's got no chance. Great goal for Cameron. He had a few of his mates come down to watch it, so they were all loving it. And then he's going to have to come off with cramp literally straight after that. And that's pretty much the last action of the game. The Reds are going to kick off again though, but I've got to say it was a great performance from BDFC, you know, for a team who doesn't really know each other, haven't really played with each other that much, only the second game for BDFC, and also to come back after 3 months of lockdown to play like this and to get a 4-0 result. It's really good stuff. Shout out again to Sepp and Brandon for putting this all together. And make sure you drop a like on the video if you enjoyed the 11ASIDE content and want to see more of it. If you're new, please subscribe to the channel. We're almost at 200 subscribers, so please help us get there. And I'll catch you next time.
Anas, fam. I'll check if it was offside later, innit?
I promise you, yeah. I stood in my own half.
I don't know if you were in your own half, but it didn't look offside to me.
No, because them lot stepped, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
No, I just stood in my own half, innit? Because you're onside. The left half is onside.
Boys, just a quick word. Brilliant today. Much better than last time. I think prep was a lot better as well, which helped. But a lot of promising signs for the games to come. I'll be looking to organise some more, maybe once every 2 months, maybe. Once every month, maybe, even if we can get boys down.